Couple of attempts at close quarters.
This is John Doe, Kyle Beach, the one-time Chicago Blackhawks prospect who says he was sexually assaulted by a coach in 2010.
I am a survivor, and I know I'm not alone. I know I'm not the only one, male or female. And I buried this for 10 years.
Interviewed today by journalist Rick Westhead on TSN. On the Blackhawks' admission, they ignored his complaints.
Trying to win a Stanley Cup was more important than sexual assault. And I can't believe that. As a human being, I cannot believe that.
John Doe deserves better from the Blackhawks.
Yesterday, team CEO Danny Wirtz released a report that found video coach Brad Aldrich used his influence with other coaches to manipulate Beach into a sex act.
It's over!
Management held off on acting to avoid bad publicity and disrupting the team during the Stanley Cup final. Aldrich was there when the team won. He raised the cup and got his name on it.
It made me feel like I didn't exist. It made me feel that I wasn't important.
Weeks later, Aldrich resigned. He went on to coach in college, then high school, where he was convicted of assault on a minor. Blackhawks general manager Stan Bowman has resigned. The report also contradicts earlier statements from former coach Joel Quenneville on the bench tonight in Florida and former assistant general manager Kevin Cheveldayoff, now with Winnipeg, that they knew nothing. Their futures may rest on convincing Commissioner Gary Bettman. Oiler Duncan Keith was on that 2010 Chicago team. He says the focus was on winning.
Maybe that's hard for people to understand, but you know, that's the truth. Not everybody knew, and I didn't know.
I do believe that everybody in that locker room knew about it. If these things happen to you, you need to speak up.
In the end, Beach never made it to the NHL. He's playing in Europe. He says hockey still has a long way to go when it comes to dealing with harassment. Cameron McIntosh, CBC News, Winnipeg.